back again with Charles Antis. This pandemic happened and I saw all the stuff you were doing with social. There's a lot of leadership stuff there. I mean, I haven't asked you directly what was going through your head. How are you navigating that?
Well, yeah, I listened to some of the last podcasts we did maybe a year and a half ago, you know, right before everything happened. And I was talking about the currency of social good, and I was saying why it's important for the future. I used the phrase, I'm going to teach you how to tiptoe into philanthropy. And then all this happened, and I've been talking about this not only inside my company, not only in Orange County and in LA, but I've been talking about this throughout the roofing community for some time. And so I've had a lot of pressure on me, to be honest, as a leader. I know that I need to somehow find a moment where I find myself. I asked myself in the morning when I got up, am I right? What if I'm wrong? Because now it matters more than ever. And I think that was a powerful moment for me. We were right on track. We discovered we needed to go double down and somehow find a way to do even more, even when there seemed like there was less to do it with. And we learned that it's not a tiptoe, it's a dive.
I love that word dive. How did you dive into it?
I dove because I was saying this and I knew I had no choice but to listen. But truth be told, dive was what was at first a pause and being frozen, not understanding. One of the other big ways we dove in is we donated meals of love for Ronald McDonald House, and we cooked meals for families, and we couldn't be inside the house. They had to lock the doors to keep the family safe. So the way it showed up was two things. I have a VP of cause who works for Antis, who is just an incredible person. She's like a sister, and her name is Susan Degrassi. And she said two things to me that broke through my fog. She said, food insecurity. I was prompted to call a friend who brings a lot of wasted food back into use. And he hooked me up with Second Harvest Food Bank. And next thing you know, I uncomfortably showed up with a mask on to deliver this box of food to the second story condo where this elderly woman lived. And I walked up and I left it there and I called. When she opened the door and I put it inside, I saw this woman standing about 10 feet from me. And she had the oldest nightgown that was very worn. She was saying, bless you. And I was still, it was uncomfortable for me. But as I turned from her, somehow that hit me again, that bless you. And that was the moment, like everything shifted. Monday and Tuesday, I mean, we just did our 37th and 38th blood drive at Antis campus. So we had this big hall, we sterilized it, we cleaned it out, and we have had, I think now 2,800 life-saving treatments of units of blood donated. We've done, I think, 250 love drops now. And me and Wing and the founder, one of the people's at KLOS Radio, one of the persons there, Wendy Ellis, Eric Morley of Blue Sea, we formed this California love drop.
You have Susan, who backs a lot of the operational side up, but how do you divvy up your time to make it all work?
Roofing contractor, and you're spending 90% of your time oversight on jobs and sales. How could you budget time to spend in what I'm doing? But you do it by dreaming you can, because you can't do anything until you change your mindset. And so you change your mindset and you say, wow, what if I could do what Charles did? Because that's what I've done with some of my friends. Wow, what if I could do what he did? And then you find that suddenly things shift. You're understood better by your own people because they see you living part of who you are. And you actually get involved with board members on this nonprofit that I told you last time needs to be a nonprofit. And when you get involved there, what happens is everything starts to shift. It's all about intention. If it's your real intention, then today, more than ever, you have to write it out.
You've mentioned a bit about the future, but what's the future hold for you? What do you see going forward?
One of the things that I see us doing is understanding our influence and our brand. You were on KTLA, a very popular local news station, three times in the last 2 weeks in some pieces about what we're doing. And I love that. But one of the things we're creating is right now under construction as we speak in Antis campus. If we were there, we'd hear the walls vibrating as we're building a podcast studio. I want to host purposeful podcasts that tell real stories that change industries. And I've never dreamed that I could lead a company like this, but this is what I get to lead today. So I'm in a happy state right now.